Okay, this is take two on this video because the sound was bad. I tried to push the cam back and apparently my computer's too noisy or something. There was a humming sound. So, I apologize for that. Here's take two on this book, How to Be Sick. It's a Buddhist-inspired guide for the chronically ill and their caregivers by Tony Bernhardt. An excellent book. Everybody who has chronic illness or is taking care of somebody with chronic illness really needs to get this book. I'll just read some of the excerpts here. An immensely wise book. Health psychology has been poisoned by the view that the best way to approach illness is through a muscular, militant resistance. Tony Bernhardt reveals how letting go, surrendering, and putting the ego aside yields insights, fulfillment, even in the presence of illness. A major contribution. Okay, the reason I'm making this now instead of waiting until Monday so I don't have another extra video up is because yesterday I had something weighing heavy on my mind that depressed me and I couldn't get it out of my head. So I turned to my handy book and I read to myself and I say this over and over again. You can change some of the words to work for you, but this: rest in natural great peace, this exhausted mind, beaten helpless by karma and neurotic thought, like the relentless fury of the pounding waves in the infinite ocean of samsara. Okay, if I just repeat something like that over and over again, it does help me release that, whatever is bothering me. Nothing else has worked, and I had to give up bodybuilding, and bodybuilding was my way of coping in the past. So now that, I'm getting warm. Now that I can't bodybuild, I find, what can I do? My mind just keeps going. So this book has been a godsend. Thank you, Tony, for sending it to me. It goes through when she got sick and how she, went through the same thing as us, fighting it, thinking, well, why is this flu not going away? And then the anger, and then the sadness, the mourning of the life that you used to have. And once we're able to just accept that this is our life, because they're really, us stressing about it or feeling bad, all that does is make us sicker. So once we can accept and just be, then it helps us a lot. If you can be a lot happier even if you're sick, if you can just accept and let things be. That doesn't mean you give up on treatment and trying to get better. No, that's not it. Turnarounds and transformations, getting off the wheel of suffering. Nothing whatsoever should be clung to. I can't read the names of who said that, but there's a whole bunch of affirmations for us to say in here, or Buddhist sayings that we can say over and over to ourselves to help. And it does help. It does. No matter how silly it may feel at first, it really does help. I'm trying to see if there's some more good ones I want to read. When we settle into the present moment, we can see beauties and wonders right before our eyes. A newborn baby, the sun rising in the sky. Okay. It's like she mentions in the book how she had listened to music but never really heard the music until she was sick and stuck in bed. And then she's like, oh. Or if you're laying in bed and you're looking out your window, you may notice things that you never noticed before you were sick. This is just a really important book and has helped my mind, which if your mind is at peace, then it can help your body be at peace. That doesn't mean that we're going to get better. It means that we're not fighting with ourselves and our illness, because that really hasn't worked for me. I've been sick for 12 years and Tony tried it, and all it was doing is causing us sadness and to feel worse, our symptoms to be worse. So I will put a link underneath the video so you can go and get this book, but it has helped more than any medicine. It just has helped me more than anything. My supplements, mind you, with my supplements, this and my other meditation, but this has been the best meditation. I have come a long ways, but like I said, I had a day yesterday and last night where I had to use the book. That's why I'm making the video now while it's fresh on my mind, because I have that fibro fog, the ME fog, and I will forget things if I don't hurry and do them. All right, I hope everyone checks into this book. You will not regret it. And everyone have a great weekend. I will talk to you later. Bye.